Let us ask God for the healing and joy and the peace that comes from serving Him. We ask for His pardon and His peace, that we may worthily celebrate these holy mysteries. Lord Jesus, you came that we might know freedom from sin and death. Lord, have mercy. Lord Jesus, you call the nations to build the kingdom. Christ, have mercy. Lord Jesus, you came that the promises of old may be fulfilled. Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Let us pray. O God, who have prepared for those who love you good things which no eye can see, fill our hearts, we pray, with the warmth of your love, so that loving you in all things and above all things, we may attain your promises, which surpass every human desire. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
Reading from the book of the prophet Ezekiel. The word of the Lord came to me. Son of man, say to the prince of Tyre, thus says the Lord God, because you are haughty of heart, you say, a god am I. I occupy a godly throne in the heart of the sea, and yet you are a man, not a god, however you may think yourself like a god. Oh yes, you are wiser than Daniel. There is no secret that is beyond you. By your wisdom and your intelligence, you have made riches for yourself. You have put gold and silver into your treasuries. By your great wisdom applied to your trading, you have heaped up your riches. Your heart has grown high from your riches. Therefore, thus says the Lord God, because you have thought yourself to have the mind of a god, therefore I will bring against you foreigners, the most barbarous of nations. They shall draw their swords against your beauteous wisdom. They shall run them through your splendid apparel. They shall thrust you down to the pit, there to die, a bloody corpse in the heart of the sea. Will you then say, I am God, when you face your murderers? No, you are a man, not a god. Hand it over to those who will slay you. You will die the death of the uncircumcised at the hands of foreigners. For I have spoken, says the Lord God. The word of the Lord. It is I who deal death and give love, life. I would have said, I will make an end of them and blot out their name from men's memories, had I not feared the insolence of their enemies, feared that these foes would mistakenly boast.
It is I who deal death and give life.
Our own hand won the victory. The Lord had nothing to do with it, for they were a people devoid of reason, having no understanding.
It is I who deal death and give life.
How could one man round a thousand, or two men put 10,000 to flight, unless it was because their wrath sold them, and the Lord delivered them up? Close at hand is the day of their disaster, and their doom is rushing upon them. Surely the Lord shall do justice for his people. On his servants he shall have pity.
It is I who kill death and bring him life.
Jesus said to his disciples, "Amen, I say to you, it will be hard for one who is rich to enter the kingdom of heaven. Again, I say to you, it is easier for a camel to pass through the eye of a needle than for one who is rich to enter the kingdom of God." When the disciples heard this, they were greatly astounded and said, "Who then can be saved?" Jesus looked at them and said, "For men, this is impossible, but for God, all things are possible." Then Peter said to him in reply, "We have given up everything and followed you. What will there be for us?" And Jesus said to him, "Amen, I say to you, that you who have followed me in a new age, when the Son of Man is seated on his throne of glory, will yourselves sit on 12 thrones, judging the 12 tribes of Israel. And everyone who has given up houses or brothers or sisters, or father or mother or children or lands, for the sake of my name, will receive 100 times more, and will inherit eternal life. But many who are first will be last, and the last will be first." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
This Gospel passage points towards something that still remains counterintuitive, still remains something that's not obvious. The disciples were astounded when Jesus said it would be hard for a rich person to enter heaven. The whole idea of riches was so that they could do what they needed to do, do what they needed to do to make life better, make life easier, to make life more complete, but now they can't get into heaven. If not then who? And this is where that counterintuitive part enters. It enters because Christ needs to remind his people that they can't save themselves. No matter how many riches they have, no matter how much intelligence they gain, no matter how much insight into the ways and things that they have, salvation still remains above them. And And so this is where the idea of giving up riches so as to focus on the true source of salvation enters. The idea of becoming vulnerable becomes strong. The idea of having less to have more. The idea of putting aside things that seem like they're up to the task, but history tells us are not up to the task. That's where things get counterintuitive. And so, like the apostles, like the disciples, we wrestle with this counterintuitive notion in our lives. And today we thank God for the times in which we've been able to grasp His wisdom. And we ask God for help as we continue the journey. We ask these things hearing that those who give up, those who detach for the sake of the Lord, will turn toward the Lord, will grow in the Lord, and will receive 100 times more, and will inherit eternal life. We seek the one who calls us, and so we join our prayers together, seeking the guidance that comes from the Spirit.
This Mass is offered for the repose of the soul of Eva Melanie Cedillo. For this intention, let us continue to pray to the Lord.
Lord,
Pope Francis, may God give him strength as he shares Christ's message with the world. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear
us. For educational leaders, for the salvation of the world, may God, through the witness of the Church, touch every heart on earth. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear
us. For educational leaders, that God will inspire them with creative options for opening classes in the fall that will help students learn and keep students and faculty safe. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord,
for an end to abortion and for the legal protection of unborn children everywhere, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord,
for our military troops engaged in dangerous missions, that they may be protected by God watching over them and return safely to their families, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord,
for the people of this faith community, may the Holy Spirit continue to inspire us in charity and compassion. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord,
for our faithful departed, including Nancy McKim, for whom Our Lady of Grace candle burns this week, may they now rejoice in heaven, God's heavenly kingdom. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear
us. For our personal petitions, let us pause in silence. For all of these, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord,
Lord God, giver of all that is good, hear our prayers and heal us. Bring us closer to you. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Thank you.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you. Fruit of the earth, the work of human hands, it will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you, fruit of the vine, work of human hands. It will become our spiritual bread.
Blessed be God forever.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Father Almighty.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice and your hands, for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and for all his holy church.
Receive our oblation, O Lord, by which is brought about a glorious exchange, that by offering what you have given, we may merit to receive your very self, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
And lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. His death we celebrate in love. His resurrection we confess with living faith. And his coming in glory we await with unwavering hope. And so, with all the angels and saints, we praise you, as without end we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the font of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the new hope, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice. And once more, giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. Giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Oscar, our Bishop, and all clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them to the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs of eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command, and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give to you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Lamb of God, you take away You take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us, Lamb of God. You take away the sins of the world. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Let us pray. Made partakers of Christ through these sacraments, we humbly implore your mercy, Lord, that conform to his image on earth, we may merit also to be co-heirs in heaven, who lives and reigns forever. Amen.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go and announce the gospel of God.